Here's a warning. This story features elements that might not be suitable for all readers, including blood, gore, violence, perilous situations, hospitalization, illness, injury, vomiting, abuse, bullying, theft, isolation, death, grief, use of alcohol, common phobias, graphic language, and sexual activity.
Okay, this is a YA book.
This is a young adult book.
Well, I like a warning.
Yeah, it's a warning. It's right up at the front, so once you turn that first page, you know what you're in for.
Well, I have to say, I often feel a little bit out of my depth with some of the YA, because this is a YA adult, like as in upper YA.
Yeah.
And like, paranormal, parasocial, romanticy. So I always check in with my teenagers when we have one of these on the shelves.
Yes.
And this has a whole lot all about it. The games gods play is all about Greek gods, mythology.
Yes.
We mere mortals walking amongst the Greek gods. And life's not so great when you come across Hades.
Yeah, Abigail Owen, she's most famous for
her guru.
Series Dominions, Inferno Rising, Fire's Edge and Brimstone Ink. There's
and
heaps
some other
of
kind
series.
Of books. Like some of her books have, you know, attractive men on the covers and beautiful ladies as well. It's so rare I throw a bone your way,
so
isn't
much.
It? I know.
I get a compliment every year. That's my one for the year.
But she writes a really diverse style of genres, but she's very well known and loved for these. And one of those authors that people go a bit crazy for when it comes to this genre.
Yeah, the fans are really obsessive in a good way. They love this type of genre. This is more like Hunger Games set in a modern world, isn't it? It involves Greek mythology, Greek gods. Now, if you were to...
Now, I heard people saying, though, it's Percy Jackson meets Hunger Games. What I'm going to say is if your kids are reading Percy Jackson, this is probably not for you. It's a little bit more grown up than that. There's a bit of language.
This is a bit... Lyra, obviously, she's the protagonist, and you've got Hades. An interesting relationship between Lyra, obviously, who's a mere mortal, and Hades, who's, like, supposed to be one of the most feared Greek gods. But some interesting banter between them. That's what I loved about the book as well. There's a lot going on as well. Every 100 years, the gods pick mere mortals to fight in these challenges, 12 challenges. Every 100 days, they need to do it. And I like those challenges, but also like the sort of the modern world, you know, fantasy world, but also I love the banter. There was good humour. I'm all for banter.
This is the first in a series, so we know there'll be more to come, and from the kind of feedback already being received, that will be very popular indeed. Where do you get this, Lee?
Oh, you can click on a button and have it delivered to you. That's pretty boring. I reckon go to a QBD bookstore and then chat to some, you know,
you'll
people.
Find someone who is cray-cray for YA, particularly all this fantasy, romantic, paranormal stuff.
Absolutely. So head in, pick it up, have a chat.